Two, three. Reloading the stream window to make sure it's running. Mute it, and we are live. Awesome. All right, so welcome everyone to 20XX. Now, for those of you who didn't attend my stream last week, and by the way, I'm sorry about my stream not being on the usual date. I had some personal issues I'd rather not get into, but let's just say it wasn't a very good day. I didn't feel up to streaming, but I feel better today, so we're gonna do this. So, what is 20XX? Well, if you didn't attend my stream last week, then, and you don't know what 20X is, 20XX, sorry, my words are a little jumbled today. I mean, they're always jumbled, but you get the drift. Anyways, 20XX is like if Mega Man X and Roguelike had a baby, really. It's a side-scrolling platformer, jump and shooter, kind of like Mega Man X, and it is randomized to the point where, like, you know, enemy placements, level layouts, item spawns, it's all randomized. And yeah, it's a really, really solid game. As you can see, I've made a lot of progress on the collection for unlocking things. The way you unlock things, you have to collect soul nuts in levels, and then after you complete a given level, after you get through a level, you can spend them in these two places. You can either spend them here to unlock items to appear in future runs, or you can spend them here to buy items you've already unlocked for, what was it? All right, to take with you on your next run. It says it up there! Wow, I'm an idiot. But yeah, just like Mega Man X, you can charge up a shot, you can wall jump. It's actually a very intuitive platformer, and I really like it. It's very well done. A lot of fun. Where's my cursor? Was my cursor on the screen? I don't think it was. But so I'm just going to quickly, hold on. I'm going to quickly promote the stream on my Twitter account. I really need to set up a, excuse me. Need to promote this so that I can, so that my Twitter followers can see it. Nice. Streaming some 20XX right now. Come join. And then my Twitch link. Enter hashtag. Just so people can see it. All right. And yeah. Things seem to be in order. Rather. All right. Well, we are ready to go, or as Shantae would say, ready to go. Okay. So I'm going to be doing something different than usual. Now these are skulls. These are basically like little things you can activate that will change up the game somehow. We've got Marathon, which makes levels longer. Famine makes health items not drop. Bankruptcy makes it so that nuts, the in-game currency, don't drop. Purist means that you don't get any speed jump or dash upgrades. Lightning means the game runs at 150% speed. Rock. Subtle. Oh, that's interesting. It does that. Spikes and pits are fatal. Remember your ancestors. So basically, if you fall into spikes or pits, you're gonna die instantly. Swarm mates, more enemies spawn, which can be hell. When the bonus timer runs out, you'll be poisoned until you die. No bonus chest, so toxin is basically like, I don't know, like you have some kind of illness, I don't know. Furor makes enemies act faster, and it stacks with lightning. Enemies deal more damage, enemies have more health. Destiny makes it so that only one next level portal at each level's end. I think I'm going to go ahead and activate that one. High Tide makes it so that zone generation level plus 4. Oh boy. Oh boy. Okay, no. And Endless. So we're going to activate Destiny and Endless. So, we're going to be doing a casual run because I'm... Okay, wait, no, I want to go buy something real fast. Oh, little technique I've noticed. If you dashed, you can actually, like, dash jump consistently. Even after the dash is technically run out. I don't know if this is a bug or a feature, but it's helped me get this a pretty tight spot, so I'm not going to complain about it either way. Okay, I'm going to get this because this is the only thing I can afford. Then we're going to go into a casual mode run because I'm kind of a scrub. And we're going to pick this loadout. Actually, no, let me take that off. And, you know what? I'm gonna take that. Just so I have a bit of an offensive buff at the beginning. And there's a soul knight enemy. There's a glowing enemy right off the bat which drops soul knights. The only ways to get these are by... I got one! The only way to get them are by killing those enemies that are, like, glowing black and bright blue, or by completing a level. There'll be some at the end. So as you can imagine, Endless Mode is kind of sort of amazing for grinding soul nuts, because you're going to get soul nuts at the end of every level and stuff, and if you have infinite, if there's an infinite number of levels, yeah, it's good for grinding. So... I will say, though, I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to get even get past the initial 8 levels, because I have a hard time doing a run as is. I've only completed one full run so far, so this is going to be interesting. This is going to be very, very interesting. Okay, jump up here. Oh, bat, there we go. He's out. Frame rate is suffering a little bit. At least on my end. I don't know if it's suffering over there. It doesn't look like it. But whatever, I can work with it. Okay, so we've got the boss right here. And I believe it's going to be Rolster. Yep. Okay, they've been adding in these boss intro screens. And they don't have them for all of them. They only have them for Rolster, Kerr, and I believe Kerr's is a placeholder, and Death Lotus. But they're so cool. Ah! I'm taking way too much damage from this guy. Yeah, this guy's not exactly an easy boss, especially at the beginning. Ugh. I'm taking way too much damage from this guy. That looks weird. And he's dead! Alright. And we got the bonus, awesome. Okay. So I'm gonna take that. We've got another one of these, we've got some more health back. One soul nut again! What the heck is my luck? And I'm gonna do the... Really? Really with this garbage? Well, that's weird. Destiny didn't work? What? Okay, let me check my, Let me check my, my boss weakness chart, see if the boss weakness for this is on here. So, I've got... Rolster is strong against Death Lotus. So... Shoot. I'm gonna go with Eternal Star. Eternal Star is easy, and plus getting the Sky Temple out of the way is always a good idea. Because this place is kind of the hardest place. It's probably one of the hardest levels. Which kind of makes sense because when this game was still Echoes of Eridu, this place was Eridu, and it was like the last level. Okay, that's a token. You can occasionally find specialized specialized vending machines and token. Oh my word. Yeah, I'm not paying attention. I'm gonna risk it. No! Oh! Wait a minute, I can get behind it. Get good, son! Oh, cool, I got 4 soul. That's awesome. Oh, whoa! I need to unbind that. I have my dash set to double tapping on movement. But the thing is that by default it's the FP, and I don't think that it unbound that, so I need to rebind it to something really hard to use. Really hard to hit. Oh my word, this... Okay, this is gonna give me a new weapon. I don't have many new weapons unlocked, so... I doubt it's gonna give me something like... Nope, it's not gonna give me something I want. Shame. Okay. But yeah, later levels, Sky Temple is horrible. Like, if I struggle on this, just keep in mind that this is like nowhere near the hardest it can get. It can get brutal. Oh, whoa, I was stuck. This is a beta game. Yeah, I highly recommend this. Like, it really is a really good game. It's in a very almost complete state. The only things missing are story, the other boss intros, and I believe some balance changes and the final boss and level. And I'm really excited for that because I really want to know what the final boss is going to be like. Can't be anything too merciful. Oh, don't dash. This would normally be easy. But, having it bound to double tapping kind of makes this a bit more difficult, but if I stay stationary, I should be able to manage it. Oh. And he hit me anyway. Crap. Okay. What's in here? Power kills might restore health. Okay. Fair enough. I mean, I would have preferred the one that makes it so that attack kills might restore health, but beggars can't be choosers, right? Better than nothing. Man, speaking of health, I am not doing too hot on it. I'm actually, like, in a really bad position right now. This could bode ill. Okay, let's take him out and then jump to the next platform. Jump! Okay, we're gonna jump over you, take you out, take you down, then we're gonna do that. That's worthless, but okay. So the boss is through here, I believe. Yeah. Boss room is over here. This boss is Eternal Star. Oh! If I can kill him quickly, I can get actually quite a bit of stuff from it. Okay, don't take another hit. Got him! Awesome! Oh, I got it! I got it! Oh my word, what the heck? I actually got health back from that. Alright, let's see. This, blah blah blah. Okay, token machine gave me... Oh, wow, okay. So, yeah, Agnizor is on this, so I need to go grab the power from the boss, because this is his weakness, I believe. I'm just going to dash jump all the way. Bunny hopping. Alright, the perforator is next. I always call him Agnizor. I don't know why. I mean, that's not his name at all, but I always call him that, because... I don't know. Ow. wow. Don't mind if I do. Okay. No, oh, no. Hey. Awesome. Alright, take you out, take you out. Jump over here, and then do that, and we are first. Jump and shoot, jump and shoot. The core essence of the game. Oh. Oh, baby. Wow, that was a good shot, and I was stacked on nuts too. I had plenty of nuts. Oh wow, armor too, awesome. You know what? This actually might be a good run. This might be a good run. I want to see if I can get a run that just absolutely breaks the game. My goal is to absolutely break this game. That's my goal. I want to completely destroy this game. I want to absolutely crash it. Because I know it's possible. At least it was possible when it was Echoes of Eridu. I'm not sure if it's been given a performance buff since then, but I want to see how far I can take this game. Can I get my... If I can't rank the game, on a technical level, I can break it on a fundamental level and just become so ridiculously overpowered that I just absolutely slaughter everything. I mean, enemies start getting... start running across stronger types of enemies as... Okay! Okay, speaking of... Okay, okay. Okay. He's dead. Good. Alright, let's go down here. There's going to be a power. Or an Og, technically. Ooh, powers deal more damage. I mentioned power and I get a power boost. Awesome. Okay, I'm just gonna let this bat come down here so that I don't have to worry about him. Take you out. Worth it. Okay, actually probably not, but you know, you get the best. Okay. Let's break that, don't need any health. Gonna let the bat fly up here and take him out. Take you down. Alright, he's out. He's out of the running. Grab the soul nuts. We're gonna jump down here. Take that. Oh, wow, okay. Alright. And the boss is over here. Awesome. Okay, so how the Shadespur works is like this. It carries your momentum with you. It's really actually quite interesting. I don't find a lot of use in it, but... Dang it. Perforator. He has a freaking machine gun for a weapon. And I'm taking way too much damage on him. This is actually not an easy boss, but it's not a hard one either. It's about medium difficulty, I'd say. His health is kind of all over the place, isn't it? Alright, bonus achievement. Okay, what's through here? We're going to check out the bosses first. Okay, we're already getting some really ridiculous, Alright, so Death Lotus. I don't have... I'm gonna play this for a bit. See what I get. Power-up's always nice. Health, always nice. Again, health, always nice. Oh. Cool, I got some currency back. Awesome. Oh my word! What the heck? This game is being generous. It's giving me a pat on the back and a shake of the hand, and then just flipped me the bird and ran off. The corporation's animal augment program serves humanity. It serves us, anyway. Oh, man. These two. I wonder if they're going to end up being the final bosses. It wouldn't surprise me. Seems like that kind of game. Okay. Oh, should I take this? I'll take this. And we'll take care of Death Lotus, because this boss needs to go, you know, like, protect that boss. I don't like Death Lotus, in case you didn't. Oh my word, there are enemies everywhere. The gates of hell opened up and spat out bats. Alright. So, this is the Vaculab. Okay. Oh. Alright, you're there. Don't cause me any trouble, alright? And dealt with. Awesome. Oh, Team Fortress 2. That actually reminds me. Something happened in Team Fortress 2, in Team Fortress 2's community recently. That was kind of big news. A huge hacking client named LMAO Box was basically erased from TF2. Everyone using it was backlinked by Valve. This is huge. This is a massive blow to the hacking community. And the funny thing is one of the people who was using the dang thing was the one who actually helped Valve get rid of it. So now an entire hacking client is gone. It looks like Valve might actually be taking a more offensive stance against hackers, and I'd be okay with that, honestly, because, well, heck those guys, right? I'm not witty. I'm not. I'm probably one of the most bland people out there, honestly. I don't make good jokes. I just kind of talk about my feelings. And even then, excuse me! Falling down by, like, flipping Geronimo right onto my head. Like some kind of anvil. Become mighty. What does this do? Oh, I think I know what this does. Should I take it? I'm gonna take it. You know what? Worth it. We're already starting to break this game into a million pieces. I love how it does that. It chastises you for trying to get out of the map. Oh, no, get away. Okay, this is a little bit hard to control! Crap! I wasn't paying attention. Ugh, wonderful. Oh well, at least I got a token out of it. Oh wow, if you're surrounded by enemies, that's actually quite useful. Never thought of that before. Now I feel like a stupid. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. You know, honestly, this seems like one of the less risk-reward... It seems like the least risky of the prototype hogs, which is what they're called. They're not called cursed items, they're just called prototype hogs. And in case you doubt me, I can actually pull up the Twitter conversation I had with the people who developed the stinking game, by the way. Oh! You know what? No, not worth it. Not worth it. I ain't having that! Good grief, my jump height is stupid. This actually might ruin me because I can't even control myself. Let's see. What did I have again? Power kills might restore health. You know, no, that's not really worth it. Oh my word, my speed is just through the roof right now. I just realized I have this power, and I wasted it completely. I could have used it to cheese Death Lotus. I'm an idiot. I'm gonna die because of this. I'm actually going to die because I... Good. Good. I'm glad that happened. I'm gonna die to Death Lotus because of this. I'm dead! I'm dead! You're dead, son! You're dead! Oh man, that was good. It was a good plan. It was a very good plan. I'm glad I did that. I'm very glad I did. I can't believe that though. I really honestly cannot believe I did that. Like, why would I do that? How could I be that stupid? Well, let's try this again. Whoa. What? No. Whoa, what was that noise? Okay, I'm going to use this instead. Because that's actually pretty good. It's a good passive. And wait a minute. Oh, we're gonna get revenge on Death Lotus! Let's make this guy pay for ruining our run. Stop giving me health when I can't use it, dang it! Well, now that's just being cruel. So if I needed health, I would need to go down there and take damage in order to grab it. Okay, now this room is just awful. Everything about it is just awful. And I could have saved that. I really could have. But I didn't. I fell into the spike. I'm really trying to not think of witty things to say. Like... Really, I am. I'm trying. But I just can't. I'm having so much trouble. I'm not a funny person. There's just awkward silence after I'm just kind of like... After just kind of single-handedly destroy my self-confidence and my ability to entertain. Eh. What do you do? I guess I'll get wittier as time goes on and I get better at this. I'm still very, very early in my streaming career, if you want to call it that. Okay, so I have a minute to kill Death Lotus. And I have less than a minute to kill Death Lotus if I want to get that bonus chest. But I don't think I'm going to get it. I wish you could... Okay. Oh! What's in here? Oh, hi! We got him down to below half health in like less than 30 seconds. Okay, this could be it. This could go well. I can do this. I can still salvage this. Yes! I did it! Got it! Less than a minute. Okay, I'll take this. I forget who his weakness is, but I don't care. Because I just killed him in a very short amount of time. Oh! Hi! Okay, I think... Let me see. If I remember correctly. Week two... I think... Okay, Kerr is weak to the perforator. Rolster is weak to the twins, if I remember correctly. Wait, no. I'm gonna try Rolster. I'm getting all mixed up about my weaknesses because I think I'm missing a boss. Oh, hi. I'll take that. I will take that. Right. More nuts! I will take that! I have, like, all of my nuts back. That I ended off the previous level, you know, with before I used the nut. No! No, don't fall. Don't fall. Don't fall. Can we just talk about the music, though? I'm gonna turn up the music, turn down the sound, and just let you guys listen. I don't want to restore it! There we go. Isn't it amazing? Ah, it's just so good. I love the sound design of this game. It's so good. Like, I might have the music down low, but it's only because it makes it harder to hear me if it's, like, really up high. We meet again, Rolster. Roll free or die! Oh, okay, that did a lot of damage to him. I don't know if that's his weakness. I don't think it is. Yeah, sometimes it does this, sometimes it does this. I think that the further you go, the more likely it is that your enemy is going to have like a second phase of- Oh, wow! Goodbye! I don't even know what just happened there. He was just... One minute he was hopping around, the next minute he's all over the place in like a million little pieces. you happen to see any stray bones, ignore them. They're technically not yours. No need to worry. Alright, and no armor. Crap. Alright, is Death... Oh wait, I already killed Death Lotus, so I don't need that, do I? Alright, in that case... I will gladly take that. Alright, so next up we have... You know, I'm gonna take care of Kerr. Because Kerr is pretty hard. So we've killed three bosses so far, I believe. No, this is the third, never mind. Oh wow, my frame rate just took a massive hit for some reason. It does this randomly. I don't like it. I'm gonna let you guys appreciate this song as well.
Thank you.
Yeah, this game, it has some absolutely gorgeous music, really. It, like, mixes modern and techno with the... Okay, here we go. Kerr the Gatekeeper. Look at this guy! He's awesome! He's so cool. And he's dead. Not a very easy boss, but... No one ever said that, anything in this game is remotely easy. Come on, come on, man. No health, are you kidding me with this garbage? You gotta be kidding me. It's garbage. It's garbage. It's garbage, Morty. I don't watch Rick and Morty. My friends, some of my friends do. So, you know, I watched one episode and then I was just like, what the heck is this? I can't take this. This is a little bit too zany for me. I legitimately was like, what the heck is even going on? Throughout that entire first episode, I didn't know what to make of it. Not a bad show by any means, it's actually quite good, it's just... It was a little bit much. Says the person who likes Deadpool. Not the movie, I haven't seen the movie. But like, the character. Okay, is there anything up here? I think I might spot something, nope. Never mind. I'm seeing things. Your old pal Robbie's seeing things, mate. I'm not right in the head. Okay, just let that shoot and then move on. Oh, nope, nope. Oh, hey, look. Secret up there. Awesome. Hey, cool. Oh, crap. Okay, this is a new weapon. Might not want it. But only one way to find out. Nope, I don't want it. They nerfed that weapon hard, and it just doesn't... It's not very good anymore. It's like it's actually kind of garbage here. Wait, did I see something like that? I did. Huh. Neat. Oh, uh-oh. Move it or lose it! Lose it. Thank you very much. Get out of my face. Oh, shut up! Alright, so this... let's see. I can get this. This is really good. And I'll get this as well. Because one, it's a health buff, and two, it makes it more likely for me to find health. Which I'm severely in need of, so as you can imagine, there's no way I'm not paying that. And let's just check what's up here. Leave health, please, thank you. There's one health, but I'll take one over none. Let's just take you out and get the soul nuts for this level. 5 soul nuts! Wow! That's really good. Alright, and I got some armor out of it too. Cool. Oh, crap. I always react too late to those guys. Okay, I have a minute to kill... I think it's Splinter Penguin? Yeah, it's Splinter Penguin. It's gotta be. Oh, and he's got a cute... Oh, no. It's Vile Spider! Oh, wow, okay, that's the weakness. He did! Alright, so, Force Nova. Are the twins next? Because that's their weakness. Yeah, the twins are on there. Awesome. Alright, fair enough. Alright, let's go! Let's face the twins in the Vacu Lab. We've already gotten Death Lotus out of the way, so we don't need to worry about him. For a little while. Alright, those things are done. dead. You're dead. You're dead. I don't know why, but something I like about this game is when there's, like, little exploits you can do to get around certain areas because of the way the level is laid out. I don't know why I like doing that. It's just kind of fun. I mean, it's probably not very sportsmanlike to be cheating the game like that, but... hey, this is a roguelike. I'll take all the advantages I can get. No powers! Oh, such a hard challenge. When I've been primarily using these. That's probably my biggest weakness in any given, like, Mega Man style game. I never use my powers for actual combat. Oh my word, what the heck is this? I stumbled into some kind of botanist convention. Or botany convention. Oh. What does this do? You know what? These are better. I was not using the dash in midair power at all, so quite frankly, this is better. Plus, it gives me a little bit of leeway with how much I can jump around, and if I fall, I can more easily recover. Oh my word, it's like a conga line of bats. Alright, 4 soul nuts. Awesome. Wonder how many that is now. Last time, when I did my first complete run, I managed to get... oh. Okay, I did a run before this report, before this, and I know what that does, and no thank you. No thank you. Basically, it adds on power every single level, but things get a lot harder, a lot faster. So as you can imagine, it's not a desirable circumstance in the slightest. Haha, I managed to collect them. Awesome. I have 49 seconds to do this. But you know what? These are the twins, and I have the Force Nova. So this is not going to be even remotely difficult. He says taking damage like right away. But yeah, I can just stand here and just do this. That power is lazy for that battle. Okay. I've already killed... is Splinter Penguin up next? Because that's his weakness. Yes, he is! Alright, I'm going to get rid of the mortar, then. Okay. Take that, and we're good. And we move on to Frostor. Oh my word, this enemy. These enemies. No. Wait a minute. I thought this only showed up in Agnizor. Apparently I was wrong. Okay. Weird. I mean, at least now I know those can spawn in a Frostor. That's kind of concerning. And it's not a glitch either, because there's multiples of them. Look. Is the game just being especially jerkish today? Oh, that's a weapon. No! Oh. Rest in pieces. Nope, no, not again. Up! Excuse me! Thank you. Okay. Got out of that mess. That was garbage. Got some of my health back. Oh. He says immediately taking damage. Immediately taking damage from really stupid sources. Alright. I'm alive and that's what matters. Alright. Oh gosh, this arena. Don't dash. Wonderful. Speak of that again. Thank you. And I got armor. Wait a minute. Hold on a second. Can I just... Nope, I can't. That's not gonna work. Never mind. It would probably work easier if my frame rate wasn't like 10 FPS. I mean, I don't know what the frame rate is on you guys' end, but my frame rate is abysmal right now. What the heck? What are you doing down here? Alright, none of these are really good, are they? I guess we'll take this. This. Oh my word, can those things stop exploding so quickly? I need the help. And we lost the bonus chest for this level. Wonderful. Good. And then we're just gonna take you out. Yes, health! Thank you! I mean, I immediately almost lost all of it, but you know what? I don't care. We're gonna take down Splinter Penguin. And we have the wrong weakness. Well, ain't that just peachy. We take one more hit and we're done. Yep, Well, at least we got enough to buy some things, so let's buy this. And I believe if I switch to Ace, that's going to proc, or work, rather. Oh, that gives him an interesting amount of range. Awesome. Oh. Awesome. Cool. Sweet. Sick. All the things! Alright, I'm gonna try and do a regular run this time. No. None of that, that fancy skull stuff. I'm just gonna do a regular, casual run. I have beaten the game with Nina, I have not beaten it with Ace. Let's fix the problem. Oh my word, that is fun! And it does a lot of damage, too. Awesome. I'm liking this. I am really liking this. Okay. And we get our health back, like, pretty much immediately. There's something up there. Probably not going to be worth it, but you know what? We're going to find out anyway. It's not like we have anywhere else to go but up. It's nuts. That was kind of worth it. Huh. Okay. Alright, how does this look when you charge it? Just like that. I want to unlock more weapons for Ace. Because, you know, Ace is cool. He's literally Zero. Except, I think he's a lot less serious than Zero, because I see him, like, with this confident smirk on his face a lot of the time. Oh, no, this is just straight up hell. Oh, run, run, run! There's no room for error here, is there? And this. You know what? I got some health, and I got some power, some extra attack power, even though it lowers my power strength. But you know what? He's Ace. You don't need powers. Who needs powers? He doesn't. He's Ace. The best swordsman around. Or rather, the second best swordsman around, because there's already a guy named Zero who's... He's like, he went with the name Ace because the name Zero was already taken. What's your name, kid? Zero. That's already taken, sorry. Oh, Ace, then. I just realized, Ace, Zero, completely different ends of the alphabet. Oh, wow, That was kind of sucky, wasn't it? Uh-huh. Jump high, cool. Let's see if I can kill the boss in, like, 10 seconds. I'll be cool if I could, but, you know, it's not gonna happen. Or apparently it is! You know, I'm gonna do a complete no power run. I'm going to use only my sword and my sword stuff. Alright, so next up we're gonna take on Kerr! Cause dragons! Da, da, da. Yeah, this is a really fun weapon to play with. Holy cow. If they gave us the ability to start off with a certain weapon of our choice, that would be really cool, because this is really fun. I like this weapon. I like it more than his base. Hey, devs. Why don't you do that? Why don't you let us select the beginning weapon? Instead of giving us a weapon halfway through the run, why not let us select the weapon we want to start with? Wouldn't that be cool? I mean, it's not like any of them are like stock upgrades. A lot of them are actually weaker. But this is just so much fun. Don't dash. Who needs the dash? I have a sword. And I'm also taking unnecessary damage because I'm an idiot. Alright, what is this? Oh. This just got good. Wait a minute. Did that do 100 damage? Maybe I should have made this an endless run. Oh. He just falls to his death, like rip. Yeah, Ace is really fun to play as. Especially with this weapon. I hope they give us, like, a character select screen. Because I do want larger art of the main characters. I really want to see them in, like, more detail. I mean, they're plenty detailed in the game. It's just that I want to see them in more detail. Is that so wrong? Like, I want to be able to see the details more clearly, I guess is what I'm trying to say. That should not have worked as well as it did. What the heck was I thinking? Oh wow, another weapon. I think I know what this one's gonna be. What the heck? You know what? No! No! I can't charge it either? What? Oh my gosh! I'm gonna try this for a bit because I just need to see this. Oh my gosh, that is amazing. Props to you devs, that's actually really funny. This is probably like a completely garbage weapon. He says as he just annihilates everything. Holy cow, this is actually pretty good. Do I want to change out, though? It's tempting, but at the same time, I was doing so well. You know, I'm going to run with this, see how it goes. This is really good. I like it. I fell to my death. Good job! Welcome to the blender, die! I don't even know. I don't even know anymore, it's just... What do you say about this? Oh, crap! No, don't... Okay. A nice thing is that, like, the last non-moving platform you landed on will be, like, a checkpoint. Okay. Did his... Okay, his eyes were, like, closed for a second, and it looked hilarious when I used it, like... You serious? He looked disappointed in me. There's a lot of things I can say about this, but I don't want to, because... Well... I try to keep things PG. Oh my gosh, this just shreds everything. This is ludicrous, I'm sorry, this is just ludicrous and stupid and fun, and I love it. It's just gonna annihilate Eternal. It's just gonna annihilate her, isn't it? Well, let's find out! Oh, Kerr, my boy, you're not in for a good time. I promise you that much. It just annihilated him! Oh, rest in pieces, mate. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness, that was hysterical. I just eviscerated him. Oh my word. Okay, let's pay Eternal Star a visit and have a little bit of fun with this guy. This is just ludicrous, I'm sorry. This is like... I cannot say anything other than why. Why is this a thing? I really hope this doesn't get nerfed, it's just... Because it's just so... The reason it's so powerful is because I put a lot of priority on taking power-up items. So it's really probably not that powerful usually, but the way it is now... It's just ludicrous. This is the ultimate in-your-face... This is the ultimate face wrecker. The wrecker of your face. I feel like I'm a chef chopping up veggies. Like, look at this. It just absolutely slashes through. It's like... What is this weapon called again? Hold on, I need to check. I really need to check. The plasma blender. It's literally called a blender. Let's make ourselves some robot smoothies, boys! I can't... I'm trying to think of things to say about this, but I think it kind of speaks for itself. In some respects. Oh, you think you're gonna put up your shield? No. No. You're not putting up your shield. I'm gonna kill you before you can. I'm gonna put you in the blender! like the times 10 spy knife. Like the, you know, in Team Fortress 2 times 10 servers, this is like the spy knife if it did actual damage. I got the I got the health pack right before I fell. I was trying to do that, but I don't know why. This is like the interception. I don't know why I found that so funny. I don't know. Oh, you think you're gonna defend yourself against the plasma blender? I just like using this weapon. I'm not even just killing things, which is just plain using it without anything in front of me to kill. That's how fun it is. Oh, watch, this is gonna be like a no attacking thing. I'm just gonna be like, nope. Nope, it's be swift! Not a problem! Eviscerated. Absolutely eviscerated. Invincibility frames? Where are invincibility frames? You're dead! You're dead! You're all dead! Everyone's dead! You're all dead! Okay. You know, from a visual standpoint, I like that more. It doesn't really do anything for me, in terms of, like, you know, actual power, because this thing can't be charged. But it's pretty cool. Looks pretty cool. Okay. And anything down here? No. Have to be frame perfect. There's literally no room for error with that. Alright, what's down here? Probably a shop or a prototype log. No, it's this garbage. It's another weapon. Yeah, no. This is just gonna absolutely eviscerate the boss, isn't it? Whatever happens in this boss battle is going to escalate very quickly. That much I'm certain of. There's nothing down here. You've wasted my time. Goodbye. Welcome to die. I will be your murderer today. Right. Now onto Eternal Star. Let's kill him in 30 seconds, shall we? Oh, this is ludicrous. I have really low health, so I'm not even remotely worried about the fight. Just look at this! Look at this! He's dead! Gracious me. We'll see. Okay, and more. Even more good stuff. What is going on? What is going on? What is going on? What is going on? Okay, what is he saying? Don't give up. You've got cleaning to do. I can't wait to watch this one die. Sorry, boys. I have a blender. By default, nothing is going to survive this. Oh my gosh, this is great. This is absolutely great. Wonderful. You know what? Let's eviscerate Death Lotus. Let's chop up some salad. The level of stupid that this weapon involves. I mean, I keep asking myself, how is anything going to survive this? But really, it's not. Like, the answer is, there's just absolutely no way it's going to happen. I mean... And watch, I'm gonna die to something ridiculously mundane because I'm getting so cocky. I have more power strength now, apparently. Oh, what? Alright. This is gonna be something stupid. This is just gonna make it even more stupid, isn't it? More run speed. So, to clarify, I'm now really fast. I can slice enemies apart faster than they can think. I'm incredibly powerful. I've got really high damage. And now I'm also a ninja. I think we've officially found one of the most overpowered combinations possible for this game. I think we've officially found one of the most overpowered combinations. This plus any sort of attack up. It's ludicrous. This is great. I love it when roguelike lets you do things like this, because... You know, I really hope they don't nerf this weapon. And if they do, I hope they don't nerf it too hard, because It's not only good, it's fun. And besides, you really have to get in an enemy's face and risk taking damage in order to use it, so it's not really that overpowered. It's dangerous to use on top of it. Don't dash. I don't think dashing is going to be much of a problem. It does have a fair amount of reach, though. I will say that much. Dang it, I dashed! I actually dashed. Rest in pepperoni me. I got some HP back, though, so... whatever. Okay, now this is actually kind of hard. I need to think carefully about how I'm going to approach this. Or I could just let my little penguin buddy kill him. That seems like the smartest choice. Alright, let's see what the shop has for me. Another one of these. And some more energy, because why not? You never know. I might change my mind about no powers. Oh, okay. Don't fall. Don't fall. Okay. And we're good. Okay. No. What was that even? Okay, yeah, this is kind of stupid. Let's see if we can kill Death Lotus in 10 seconds. Oh my word. Ace the living blender. I have become a walking blender. Oh, oh. Oh, rest in... Again, with the really fast... Every single boss is just absolutely annihilated by this. And I'm getting even more health. What is this? I think this game is deliberately not giving me health because it knows how powerful I am. It's trying to kill me. The weapons engine on top. They know. I don't need weapons. I just need the blender. Okay. Okay. Devs, please add in some. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh, just like, what the heck is this one doing? Okay, if anyone's gonna kill me, it's gonna be this guy. But it's not anything that comes before it, I can say that much. Okay, let them go, and then run, run, and run. I shouldn't get cocky, really. Because, I mean, this is powerful, but the thing is, bosses are very easy to get in the face of and kill with this. Normal enemies and platforming can still kill me. So if I get too cocky, it's a recipe for disaster. And speaking of recipes for disaster, why would you put this many bats in such a small place? There had better be an achievement for this. For completing an entire run without nabbing any powers. Alright. I'm gonna kill you. Get armor. I'm gonna kill you. Get soul nuts. That was really funny though. They were like, is this one okay? Maybe it thinks it has something to prove. And I'm like, I have nothing to prove. This is just way too fun. I'm cheesing bosses with a weapon, with an attack and not a power. And now I have more attack strength. Game! Okay, I can't decide if this game wants me to be overpowered or if it wants me to die. It's legitimately hard to tell at this point. Be swift? Gladly! Not the bees! Not the bees! What's my current helmet? Nothing. Okay. Again, this game doesn't want me to die. Oh, get me out of there. Okay. There's a shop down there. Let's see what it's got. I actually can't afford anything now. Crap, never mind. Oh, I'm actually pretty low on health. This could get bad. Oh, I fell all the way down. Okay, don't take stupid damage. Come on, health. No. Okay, I actually might die here. I mean, I put on a bit of a show, but I actually am in trouble right now. Oh! Oh! Armor. Never mind. Really? With that? Okay, the boss is right here. I just have to not die on it. I have 4 health. Oh, I died! I should have waited and focused on dodging. Oh well. That was a stupid run, but it was a really good one. And that was fun and hilarious. That is my favorite weapon in the game now. Alright, let's see what I can buy here. I can finally buy this. This has been bothering me. What is this? Oh wow! First off, I need to see how this looks. That actually looks really freaking sweet. I like... Oh, it goes through walls. It goes through walls. Oh. I'm gonna do one more run as this, and then I'm gonna see if I can round up someone to play some multiplayer with me. Wow. This is... This is actually really good now that I think about it, because it goes through walls. I can attack things from behind walls. This makes playing it safe a lot easier. I'm getting really careless, though. It's not good. Oh, wow, they just straight up intercepted it, like, dead on. Oh, this guy. Okay, grab him. Okay, that guy is like a beggar in Binding of Isaac. He'll pick up coins, but when he gets enough, this game will... Okay, I need to stand on here. He'll pick up your currency. Pick up currency, but when he gets enough, he'll give you stuff. Now, the Skittery Smuggler will only give you stuff once, and I got one soul now, are you serious? But, he gives you three items at once. Every single time I see him, I take it. Okay, we're starting with the twins. Twins are down. That didn't go particularly well, but... another Skittery Smuggler. Holy cow, what the heck? I'm gonna use it... Okay, I don't think it's a weakness for Splinter Penguin. Ah, crap. I'll just go to Eternal Star, I guess. Because I am not liking my chances of defeating anything else right now. So yeah, you can see that the smuggler is getting bigger as he eats more nuts. The bigger he is, the closer he is to giving you things. And I think he's about... Yep, he gave me some. Okay, I thought he gives me three items. Oh well, I'll take two over none. He's given me three items before. I guess it just must be randomized which one he goes with. Okay, he got a soul nut so far. Yeah, I've been able to consistently get farther than usual, which is nice. Had to pick that up, otherwise he wouldn't have gotten it. He would have gone the waste. Had to pick it up. This does make precision a little more difficult, though, so I am seeing a bit of a trade-off here. But at the same time, it is pretty useful. That ability to shoot through walls is gonna help at some point. I mean, it's not really gonna help here, but I can see it helping in the Vacuum Lab or in Frostor or Agnizor. Let's try that again, shall we? And this time with less suck. I do love exploits in these kind of games. If we can hit it! Okay, yeah, again, accuracy is... Goodbye! I love how enemies in this are affected by the moving platform, so fast you get, like, shoved down. It's kind of hilarious. Okay, let's not take stupid damage on this. Alright, smuggler's grabbing things. Alright. Now I can dash all I want, even though I probably won't. Oh. Oh, bonus rewards. Awesome. Up. Okay, that was my fault. That was completely my fault. I can't blame anyone else for my own stupidity. Because, like, if you'll just hit him! For crying out loud! Starting to kind of dislike this weapon, if I'm perfectly honest. It's probably a shop up there. Or death. Whoa, what? Oh, what? That exists? What? Well, anyway guys, my throat is kind of starting to itch a bit, and I'm getting a little tired, so I'm going to end this off here. Thanks to everyone who came, and I hope you had a great time. If you're watching this on YouTube, hope you like it. Be sure to tell me what I can do to improve future streams. And as always, guys, I'll see you next time. Stay sensational.